Thank you. Thank you. See you later.
You're back.
Yeah.
Seafoam, listen to my voice. My shouting, bellowing voice. Here I am, pouring my blood into my words, yelling at the very edge of the world. I am the Little Mermaid, unable to return. The Little Mermaid, fated to foam. I said no.
Welcome home!
Thank you. Welcome back.
And now, the weather. The week ended on a wet note as rain clouds moved into the area. As a result, a thick fog is expected to form in the Inaba region later tonight.
Yo! Yo! All right! Sorry. Hey, you... Thanks. All right. See you later.
Welcome back.
Hi there!
Where'd the manners come from?
Well, I didn't know you guys were my senpai. Thanks a bunch. Though, I don't really remember what happened.
There are some things we'd like you to tell us about.
First off, boy you met with?
I really don't know much about him. I mean, I've only met him twice.
Yeah, but you walked home from school with him. What did you guys talk about?
Well, he just asked stuff like if anything different happened lately. But I don't know where my head was at. When I came to my senses, I blurted out that I wanted to see him again.
To a guy.
I don't really get it myself. Girls are so loud and obnoxious, so, you know, I really don't like dealing with them. Guys are a lot more laid back. So, I started thinking, what if I'm the type who never gets interested in girls? And I couldn't accept that. So I kept spinning around and around in my head.
Well, I can understand the part about feeling more relaxed around dudes.
I'm fine now. I mean, it was all in my head when you get down to it. I was the one shutting out that stuff. So, our family's run a textile shop for generations. Oh yeah, you already knew that. My parents are kind of weird. They say stuff like, dyes are one with the universe, and cloth is alive. And that's the kind of house I grew up in. So I've been interested in sewing and stuff since I was a kid. The second I say stuff like that, people look at me funny. Girls make fun of me, the people in the neighborhood treat me like I'm some zoo animal. So I was sick of everything. And when I got to my senses, I was running wild. Shit, what is with me today? I'm going on and on about myself. Forget all that. Man, I must look really lame right now. I doubt it. I've never talked about any of this stuff before. Guess I never had anyone to tell it to. I guess I wasn't really afraid of girls. I was just scared of people in general. But all that's behind me.
Wow, I'm surprised. You're a good kid.
Don't call me a good kid.
No need to get embarrassed. You're a big guy, you can take it. Hey, is there anything you remember after you ran into us the second time? You know, after you chased us away and said you were gonna take us down?
Huh? I went home. I was gonna sleep it off in my room. Wait, I think someone came...
to your house? Who was it?
Well, it was just a feeling I had. I mean, I don't know if anyone actually came. Other than that, I remember some weird, dark entrance thing. And when I woke up, I was laid out on the floor of that sauna place.
A dark entrance. Could it have been a TV?
Huh? Well, now that you mention it, maybe so. Why do you ask?
Oh, no reason. I was... just wondering.
Did the police ask you anything?
Well, my mom had called the cops to look for me, so they questioned me for a while. I told them exactly what I just told you. And they looked at me like I was crazy. So, like, are you guys playing detective or something?
Well, something like that.
Anything I can do to help? If there's some bastard out there who put me through this, I ain't gonna rest until I make him pay.
Seriously? Awesome. You'd make a great addition to our team. What do you say, leader?
Thank you, sir. I'll put my life on the line for you guys. I'll do my best.
Well, if we're gonna welcome aboard a new member...
should we take him to our special headquarters?
We're still calling it that?
What's that?
Come on, let's go. Man, you eat a lot. Were you listening to what we were saying?
Huh? Well, sure, I was listening.
Ah, close your mouth.
So someone's killing people with the TV? What is he, beating them to death?
No, they weren't being beaten with a TV. Were you listening at all?
Don't worry. He'll understand once he sees the place with his own eyes. But the way it happened was just the same as with Yukiko. The killer kidnapped him first, then threw him into the TV.
Yeah, it's scary.
That show's been pretty crazy lately, huh?
Yeah, I keep wondering who'll show up next.
I knew before I came on that he'd be the next one to appear. What's that dude's name? That first year who used to be in a biker gang?
Who the hell do you think was next? His name is Kanji Tatsumi. And he wasn't in a biker gang. He's the one who beat the shit out of those leathered up pansies. So who are you, dipshits? Boring.
I can't stand it. Sure, they have no idea it's related to the murders, but still, how can they talk about their schoolmate like that?
They're like onlookers at a car crash. As long as it's not happening to them, they're dying to see. Damn, this sucks. We don't even know who's gonna be targeted anymore.
This case disproved our assumption that all the victims are female.
What was the other thing we thought they had in common?
People involved in the initial case about Miss Yamano are the targets. How about that?
But that announcer was involved with their mothers, not them.
You guys saying you don't have any clues? Well, listen up, because I got something big.
What's that?
Okay, when I made my comeback at school today, there was an annoying brat hanging around. Turns out, he was snooping around about senpai's and my disappearance. So I took this from him. I don't know what the hell this all is, though.
And you took it anyway?